My name is Philipp Hensler and I present Unsupervised Learning of 3D Object Categories from Videos in the Wild. This work was completed during an internship at Facebook AI Research in London. Given object-centric videos of a specific category, our goal is to train a deep neural network that at test time is able to reconstruct a 3D shape and appearance from one or multiple images. While previous works have focused on using synthetic data or isolated views of real data that require templates, post-supervision, or other manual annotations, we are interested in the challenging case of real-world data where only object-centric videos and their corresponding object masks are given. As currently no appropriate dataset exists for our task, we introduced the AMT Objects dataset, a large collection of object-centric videos that we collected using Amazon Mechanical Turk. In a second step, we post-processed the raw videos autonomously using structure for motion in order to retrieve 3D annotations. A naive solution for our task would take an image of an object and encode it as a global encoding Z. Consequently, multiple images of the same object would be enforced to have the same encoding. A shape decoder would then take the encoding and return the opacity and color of the object at a given 3D location X. However, structure for motion does not ensure that objects will have the same scale or will be aligned canonically. For instance, two different runs of structure for motion can result in two reconstructions of the same 3D shape related by an arbitrary similarity transformation. As mentioned before, a naive encoder that encodes images to global latent codes, such as the embeddings Z1 and Z2, which are identical, would have to represent two different objects, which is not possible. To overcome this issue, we propose our novel warp condition ray embedding as explained next. Given one or multiple views of an object, our method reconstructs the corresponding shape and appearance in form of a neural radiance field. First, we feed each given source image through a resonant encoder and upsample all intermediate feature layers to the input resolution, resulting in per pixel features. We then shoot rays from the target view through the neural radiance field and sample points along the ray. Next, we backproject each sample point into all given source views and retrieve the per pixel features, which we refer to as warp conditioned ray embedding. In the case where multiple source images are given, we aggregate the features at each sample location, weighted based on the angle between the source ray directions and target ray R. A lower angle indicates a higher weight and vice versa. Next, we pass the accumulated pixel-wise features along with their corresponding 3D world coordinate and target ray direction to the neural radiance field, which returns opacity and color values. We compute a step for each sample location along the ray. Finally, we employ differentiable emission absorption rendering in order to retrieve our final per pixel RGB value. We evaluate our method against baselines that make use of different shape representations. The first competitor is a conditioned form of NeRF. Secondly, we compare to two voxel baselines, where the first one is based on a simple voxel grid, while the second one uses a local MLP that is conditioned on voxel features. And lastly, we compare to a mesh baseline inspired by DIBR. We show comparisons of our method with all baselines on single view reconstruction. We demonstrate multi-view reconstruction. The top row shows all seven available source images, while the second row shows reconstructions for 1, 3, 5, and 7 source images. Our method, compared to the best performing baseline, the MLP-only one, is significantly better in terms of RGB L1 error and also absolute depth error for the task of novel view synthesis. For more information and details, please visit our project webpage. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out. Thank you.